Welcome back to Tech Garage, presented by rockauto.com. Well, I'm actually not a doctor, but I do play one on Tech Garage, a brake doctor, that is. Welcome to the Garage Edge segment. You know what? I told you we were going to talk about every system on this board, and we're going to talk about it in depth. Well, we made it down to the drum brake systems. So to understand drum brake systems, let's take a look at a couple of types of drum brakes. This first one right here, this is actually a dual servo or a Bendix type brake system. What does that mean? Dual servo, two actions. That's pretty cool. You got a primary shoe right here, and then you have a secondary shoe. The vehicle direction would be in this direction here. The primary shoe is the shorter in length. You can see it's a little bit shorter than the secondary shoe. Always faces towards the front of the vehicle. Now, dual servo is pretty cool. You got a wheel cylinder, you got some springs, and you got a star adjuster on the bottom. Well, what's happening? Two motions. When your car stops, the primary shoe kind of takes a ride with the brake drum and it moves around. I can slide it over and it's going to transfer the energy through the star adjuster to the secondary shoe. Secondary shoe is going to do most of the stopping, hence the longer lining. Sometimes different coefficients of frictions, so make sure you put them on your car in the right direction, or it may stop real good in reverse, but we want to stop in forward. Then there's the leading trailing. Now the leading trailing, a little bit different. Not dual servo, not double action. What happens here is you see the wheel cylinder, and then we go through a shoe, and then bam, it all stops right there at this fixed point. What's going to happen is the wheel cylinder is going to push the shoe out, and we kind of use a wedging effect. It gets wedged in the actual brake drum itself, and that does most of the stopping. This one comes back, transfers the energy back into the wheel cylinder, and gets wedged on this side. So two types of drum brakes. Now a couple tips for you. Anytime you're doing drum brakes or doing a brake inspection, it's a good idea, man. rockauto.com, I just, voila. I mean, geez. I mean, there's a lot of parts. Tip for you, take a picture of the brakes, one side, before you start messing with the other side, because you could have springs, return springs, star adjusters, you know, kinds of different e-brake adjusters, hold downs, you name it, the system may have it. I got this kit so I can replace all the springs. When they start to get tempered or heat checked, you can tell when you're taking them on and off. What do I mean by taking them on and off? Well, you can take your drum off here, and if you have to, you're gonna have to replace these shoes. Like I said, take a picture of the other side so you have a reference to look at of what's going on. Now, once again, rockauto.com, they actually sell tools, all kinds of brake tools. Just go to the tool section. We got a whole kit that does discs and drums. So I can use this as a spring retractor. I can use this side to pull some springs. If I want to adjust the star adjuster, I have everything in the set. Now, a couple tips for you. You may be going down the road and you have a disc drum system. Your pedal may be a little bit low. One or two pumps, it starts to raise up. You probably have misadjusted rear brakes. Why? Well, in a prior episode, you saw that disc brakes are self-adjusting. The fluid goes back there and it keeps the pad in contact with the rotor. Drums, not so much. And the star adjusters, well, they just don't work too great. So you want to take it apart, take some sandpaper, sand them down, clean them up real good, get that coefficient of friction, get you some brake clean, clean them off, make sure they're in really good shape. Another trick for you, you can go ahead and pry up on the brake pad. There's three raised ledges. Those are called bosses. That's actually where the shoes ride. Only three places. One here, here, and down here. So I'll take a little brake lube. I'll pry it up. Be sure not to get it on the shoe or the material itself. Put a little bit in there so every time I apply the shoe brakes, they come out, the drum brakes and the shoes come out, and you don't have any squealing on the backing plate itself. So you can see there's a lot of components. You can actually go and look at them right there on this graphic. Make sure you clean it, make sure you adjust it, make sure you service them. Every time you do a brake job, it's good to do a good visual inspection on the rear brakes as well.